Today I am going to discuss the topic counter. So it is a topic from digital electronics. So I'm going to explain. So what is a counter? What are the applications of the counter? So how can we construct a counter using some kind of memory elements like flip flops? So before discussing this topic, so first I want to define this counter. So counter is a device which counts the number of clock pulses applied to it. So counter is a device which counts number of clock pulses applied to it. So it counts number of clock pulses in a given signal. So what is the use of the counter? So generally we use counters in real-time applications wherever you need a counting process. For example, some parking area is there. You want to count how many vehicles are entered into some parking area. So there you can use this counter. And for example, if there is a classroom, you want to monitor how many people have been entered into the class. So you can use the counter automatically to count how many people have entered into the classroom. So these counters are real-time. We have more real-time applications using counters. So that is the real-time application. So my question is, how can we construct the counters? So before constructing the counters, I want to classify the counters. So basically, counters are of two types. One is asynchronous and another one is synchronous. Counters are of two types of counters, asynchronous counter and synchronous counter. So the process is same. Asynchronous counter counts the number of clock pulses and of course synchronous counter counts the number of clock pulses. But the way we give the clock signal and the way we give the input differentiate these two. So in asynchronous counter we have the flip-flops. So we know that flip-flop is a memory element which stores 1 bit. So flip-flop or latcher is a memory element, so which stores 1 bit element. In synchronous counter also we have the flip-flops, but in asynchronous counter we give the clock signal to a first flip-flop. After the output of first flip-flop is given as clock to the second, and the output of second flip-flop is given as third flip-flop, right? This process will continue. This is the clock application in asynchronous counters. So we give the same output to all flip-flops. Coming to synchronous counters, in synchronous counter, clock is same for all the flip-flops. We apply same clock to the all the flip-flops, but the input is different. So in this input is same, clock is different. In this clock is same, but the input is different. So in this asynchronous counter, we use flip-flops. In synchronous counter, we use flip-flop. Asynchronous counter counts and synchronous counter also counts. But how we are giving the clock signal and how we are giving the input signal? So where is the synchronous and asynchronous counter? Now I want to design this asynchronous counter. So I am going to design this asynchronous counter. So I am going to discuss how can we design asynchronous counter. So this asynchronous counter can also be called as ripple counter. The other name for asynchronous counter is ripple counter. So if I want to, so before designing any counter, we should have in our mind how many clock pulses should my counter count. So in your application you need 10. For some applications we need 100. For some applications we need 1000. Based on our requirement, we need to use the corresponding flip-flops. For example, in your application, you want to count 8 clock pulses. If you want to count 8 clock pulses, you need three preferreds. This we have a formula for that, that is 2 power n greater than or equal to capital N. So here 2 power n is the number of flip flops required to construct counter, and whereas capital N is the how many clock pulses that you want to count. So 2 power n greater than or equal to n, this should be, we should clarify. Sorry. So based on this formula, we can get how many flip-flops that my circuit should have. We need to satisfy this formula. Okay. For example, if I want to count 3 more, if I want to count 8 clock pulses, if I want to count 8 clock pulses, 2 power 1 greater than or equal to 8. So this is wrong. 2 power 2 greater than or equal to 8. This is wrong. 2 power 3 greater than or equal to 8. This is right. So if I want to count 8 clock pulses, my circuit should consist 3 flip flops. Like this, we can insert flip flops into the circuit based on our requirement. So this is what about how many flip flops should be needed to construct a synchronous counter. Now, so we are applying the clock signal. So in clock pulses, we have three kinds of clock pulses. It is a level trigger, and it is a pulse trigger. Sorry, edge trigger. It is a pulse trigger. Level trigger, edge trigger, and pulse trigger. We have three kinds of clock signals that I can apply to any flip flop as a clock. So I may use this. I may use this. Again, these three have a negative formation also. So, for example, this is a positive pulse clock. So it is a negative clock pulse. It is a positive clock pulse and it is a negative clock pulse. So we can use these three. So it is your requirement whether you are using positive clock or negative clock. It depends on your application. Okay. Now I can use any of these three for my flip-flops as a clock. Now I am going to construct one circuit, that is one asynchronous circuit using these flip-flops. So randomly I want to construct 3-bit asynchronous counter. I want to draw 3-bit asynchronous counter. So 3-bit asynchronous counter can count 8 clock pulses. 3-bit asynchronous counter can count 8 clock pulses. So how many flip flops that I need? The number of flip flops that I need is 3. So if I want to construct 3-bit ripple counter, I want to use the 3 flip flops in the circuit. Now I am going to draw the circuit. So especially when you are designing this ripple counter or asynchronous counter, we use 2 flip flops, either JK flip flop or T flip flop. Using JK or T, we can easily design this asynchronous counter. Now I am using the JK flip flop. So as I am saying, we need to have 3 flip flops. I am going to design my counter using 3 flip flops. So I apply clock signal here. So I am naming it as A, and it as B, and it as C. So it is JA, A, QA, QA. So these are the two inputs of my JK flip flop, and these are the two outputs of my JK flip flops. I have three JK flip flops, A, B, C. So in each flip flop, we have two inputs and two outputs. So again, we have JB, KB, QB, and QB bar. So JC, KC, QC, and QC bar. So I am connecting all these inputs to Finally, 1. Because we know that in JK flip flop, toggles in 1-1 condition. That's why I am fixing the input here 1. So all these are connected to 1. All these inputs are connected to 1. Again, so here, for each and every flip flop, we need a clock. As I am saying, it is asynchronous. Asynchronous counter. The first flip flop output is should connect as a clock to this. So I am connecting Q bar or Q as a clock to this. Again, I am connecting this as a clock to this. So my outputs are QA, QB, and QC. These are my outputs. So this will be displayed like. QC, QB, QB. These are my outputs for my corresponding flip flops. So, what is the operation? How can this circuit be operated? So, initially, when the clock signal is supplied to a static flip flop, we know that the JK flip flop toggles by a corresponding clock signal. So, whenever the clock occurs, this flip flop toggles. That means if the previous input is 0, my present will be 1. If the previous is 1, my present will be equal to 0. This flip flops toggles according to the clock signal that I applied here. Toggles according to the clock signal that I applied here. And for this flip flop, based on the output generated by this flip flop, because the signal that is coming from this flip-flop acts as a clock to this. So based on the output of this flip-flop, this will toggle. So whenever the clock signal, so the output of this acting as a clock. So whenever positive pulse occurs, this again toggles. And the output is connected as a clock to this. So based on the output of this, this flip-flop toggles. So overall, if you see the timing diagrams of the circuit, based on the timing diagram, how it is counting, we can say. For example, I am drawing the timing diagram. So this is the clock signal that I am measuring. So this clock signal we are giving as an input to first flip flop. So my output of first flip flop is whenever the clock occurs, automatically it toggles. Initially I measured it 0. Whenever clock occurs, it goes to high. Again, whenever clock occurs, it goes to low. It toggles for each and every clock process. So here I have a clock, that's why it changes its output. And here I have a clock pulse. Again, it will change its output. If it is 0, it will go to 1. If it is 1, it will go to 0. So like this process will repeat for each and every clock pulse. Now, this signal is acting as a clock to B filter. So this is the clock. Now, this is the clock is applied to my second flip flop. So based on this clock, my QB value will depend. Based on this flip flop, my QB value will depend. So whenever this occurs, like this, here the signal goes. So this is the clock signal for my third flip flop. So QC value will be like this. If you take the values, initially these are 0, 0, 0 and 1, 1, 1, next, third flip flop, 1, 1, 0, next, third flop, 1, 0, 1, like this the counting goes. So, how the counting goes like this is, initially 0, 0, 0, next 1, 1, 1, next 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, it goes to next, like this, 1, 1, sorry, 1, 0, 1, next, 1 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 0 0, 0, 0. So it is like this, it is counting. So I can say that it is a asynchronous counter counting three clockwise, but it is a down counter. It is counting in reverse order. That's why I am calling it as down counter.